Before starting this video, I'd like to say a big thank you to my 10 loyal subscribers. Okay, we are good to go now. The candy desk has been a tradition of the United States Senate since 1968. This is a specific desk with candies, near a busy entrance in the Senate. The senator that sits at this desk is responsible for keeping a drawer full of candies, and the lord of the sweets at the moment is the Pennsylvania Senator Pat Toomey. It all started in 1965, when California Senator George Murphy joined the Senate. He was keeping candies on his desk for him and his colleagues, although eating is not allowed on the Senate floor. But the rules are made to be broken, especially when you can have a candy at your hand. When he left the Senate after a six-year term, other Republican senators maintained the custom. The tradition was a secret until the mid-1980s, when Washington Senator Slade Gordon disclosed it by announcing that he would be sitting at the candy desk. I would like to see the faces of the people who heard a senator saying, "I'll be sitting at the candy desk. It is mine now." The candy desk had also some dark periods. Issues began in 2006, when the Senator Craig Thomas occupied it. The state where he was coming from, Wyoming, did not have members of the National Confectioners Association, and therefore no candy makers large enough to donate candies to fill the desk. Allow me to open a small parenthesis here. The NCA is the trade organization that advances, protects and promotes chocolate, candy, gum, and the companies that make these special treats. Moreover, it is forbidden for a senator to accept gifts worth $100 or more from the same source. The candy desk and the sweet-loving senators were in a big danger at this moment. However, these issues were worked around by asking many small Wyoming confectionery businesses and chocolatiers to donate small amounts of candy to fill the desk. By the way, if you are from the United Kingdom and are laughing now at the United States, I'd like to inform you that since 1694 you have a snuff box at the door of the House of Commons. And that's all for today, folks. See you next time.